I wish to inform the public that the government of Kenya, through the National Bureau of Statistics, has completed all preparatory activities for the 2019 Kenya Population and Housing Census, due to commence the night of 24th and continue up to 31st August this year. This is a culmination of a careful, systematic planning that started way back in 2016, which started from cartographic mapping that established 129,123 enumeration areas, and later conducted a pilot census exercise in August last year. This indeed tested adequacy of logistics, personnel, accuracy of the maps, as well as admissibility of the questionnaires and other data capture applications. I also wish to confirm that it's all systems go, as all necessary personnel for the exercise have been recruited, trained, and deployed to their enumeration areas. The training of field census personnel started with the training of trainers on 15th July 2019 and ended with the last group, the enumerators, on 20th August 2019. It is imperative to note that a total of 129,123 enumerators have been deployed to cover conventional households, while additional 9,000 enumerators have been trained and deployed to cover special populations like in the restricted areas, prisons, police cells, travelers and hospitals, and will further be used as reserves in case of any of the enumerators dropouts. The enumerators are further supported by the village and the community elders in conduct of the exercise to ensure smooth entry and wholesome delivery of the same. In addition, all materials to be used during the enumeration exercise have been distributed to various county headquarters for onward distribution to the census personnel. The mobile devices and accessories have also been delivered to all the counties and will be distributed to all census personnel. Other materials are expected to be distributed to the census personnel before the end of the day, today. On publicity and advocacy, I wish to inform that sensitization of the various groups and the general public on the census have been going on progressively. An elaborate plan on the targeted groups and the key messages have been developed, and various user groups briefed accordingly. This briefing will continue throughout the census period. And we have set up a center, a communication center, that will be sending out messages on an hourly basis to confirm the exercise is ongoing as planned. And should there be any challenges, this will be brought to the attention of the people in charge for immediate mitigation. It is envisaged that preliminary results will be released 3 months after the end of the exercise, while the basic reports of the census are expected to be released within 6 months. The final detailed analytical disaggregated reports will be released within 1 year after the census enumeration. At this stage, I also want to state, in the interest of transparency and openness, I wish to state that of the total budgeted figure of 18.5 billion for the exercise, it's important to clarify that this amount is spread over 5 years, from the financial year 2016 to the financial year 2020. The detailed breakdown of costs as per budgeted activities in cash shillings are as follows. At the design, development, and planning of the census process, about 255 million was used. In carrying out the cartographic mapping exercise, which was done 2 years ago, 2.5 years ago, over 3 billion was used. In the area of publicity and advocacy, about 500 million was used. In the conduct of the pilot census, about 118 million was used, while the main enumeration area that will be taking place will cost us about 10 billion. ICT equipment and softwares will consume also another 3 billion. During the analysis and dissemination, We'll also need about 200 million for the exercise. It's important to know that the biggest proportion of the budget goes towards the emolument of the census personnel, who include mapping assistants, enumerators, supervisors, and also payment of allowances for local administrators and village elders, as well as purchasing of the mobile devices. It is gratifying to know that the utilization of this budget resulted in direct and indirect benefits to the economy. The first was the transfer of technology to assembly of devices by two local universities, because the devices that are going to be used for this exercise are actually manufactured here in Kenya by two of our universities. So you can imagine the level of technology transfers, and that these devices will later on be used for other exercise that's going to happen in the country. Additionally, it's going to create over 200,000 jobs. The government wishes to assure all Kenyans that the information provided will be treated with utmost confidentiality in conformity with the UN fundamental principles of official statistics and as stipulated in the Statistics Act 2006. All residents are encouraged during the exercise to cooperate with the teams that will visit them for the census enumeration, and thus every person should provide accurate information during the period. I also wish to state that all the available resources have been already sent to the various counties for payment of the individuals, the personnel involved, and for any attendant cost. So nobody should complain because money have been transferred. And for at the end of the exercise, the individual enumerators and other census personnel will be paid directly through their bank accounts that have already been provided to our systems on their own accord. About the village elders and local administrators, payments will be done through the census, county census committee, and money have already been transferred to this effect. At this stage, I now want to appeal to all Kenyans to consider this as a patriotic duty and cooperate with the people involved in the exercise, in the enumeration, so that we realize maximum result. We are therefore saying to all Kenyans, Jitokeze Wesabike.